Hello everyone, in this lesson I'm going to show how to install Git and the initial necessary configuration. First of all, Git installation depends on the operation system you're using. For example, as you can see, in the Git download page we have options for Windows, Mac and Linux. I'm using Windows here, so I'm going to show the Windows installation first. Later on, I'm going to show how to install on Linux and Mac. First, for Windows, you can download the Git installer from the Git page, this one here. After downloading it, you can run the installer and it will install multiple Git softwares in your computer, such as a graphical user interface and a bash terminal. In this course, I'm going to use the bash terminal, which is this one. The advantage of the bash terminal is that it uses Unix-like commands, so it is more similar to what you will find in other operation systems, such as Linux and Mac. For example here, we can check that it has been successfully installed by running git /version. Then it will show the installed version of Git. Now, the Linux installation is very simple, since it is available on package repositories. For example, if you're using Debian-based distributions, you can simply run apt-get install git, and this will install the Git package, and then you can start using Git as I have just done in Windows. You can use it on the Linux terminal. Finally, on Mac, you can install it by running git /version on the terminal. If you don't have it installed, the system will prompt you to install it. Also, if you prefer, you can use the Mac and Linux installers from the download page as well. Now, pause the video and install Git on your system. Then come back and you're going to configure it for first usage. Git comes with a configuration tool called gitconfig. This tool allows you to set different configuration variables for Git, such as your name, email, and default text editor. There are three types of configuration variables. System variables are those that are configured using gitconfig /system, and those will be valid for all the users in the system. For example, if I set one here on my computer, all the users in my computer will have the same configuration. The global variables are set using gitconfig /global, and they will be valid for all repositories created by your user. So if I set one here, it will be valid for all the repositories that I'm using in my user. And the local variables are only set with gitconfig, and they will be valid for a single repository. For example, I'm going to open the git bash terminal here, and let's set some configuration variables. The most basic ones are your name and email, and those are actually required to use Git, because all your commits will have your name and email on it. Since we want the name and the email to be the same for all my repositories, I'm going to set it as a global configuration variable. So gitconfig /global user.name, and then I put my name. Now, for the email, user.email, and then I put my email. Since I don't have space characters on my email, I don't need to put the quotes here. Finally, we can check if those variables are correct by running gitconfig /list. This will list the currently set configuration variables. So here, as you can see, I have the name and the email here correct. And that's it for this lesson. In the next one, I'm going to explain the basics of how version control systems work.